this panel. I damn you, baby, unleash my dogs of war. And the first dog that I would like to introduce to you, WinterCon, is my personal Mad Max cosplay guru, Carl Bartoszynski, the man who is in charge of MadMaxCostumes.com and one of the founders of the largest post-apocalyptic party in the world, Wasteland Weekend. Oh, my dogs, give it up for Carl.
Thank you, guys. It's really great to be here. What an amazing panel we have for you today. And what an amazing reunion we have for you today. It's been 35 years since the making of Mad Max 2 The Road Warrior. And it's also been about 35 years since some of these guys have seen each other. So this is a really amazing thing here today. There have been four films in the franchise: Mad Max, Mad Max 2 The Road Warrior, Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome, and of course Fury Road, which came out last year. I still have to say that as awesome as Fury Road was, I still think Mad Max 2 The Road Warrior is still my favorite film of them all. Right. It's just such a classic. It's a post-apocalyptic western samurai film. It was back in the days when you didn't see a lot of visual effects in films. Everything was done in camera. It's just a very, very classic, wonderful film. So, I'm going to begin introducing the actors we have here today. They flew from all over the place, Los Angeles, Australia, the UK. I myself flew from Los Angeles just for this, to be here for this. It's very historic. All right, so our first actor. Introducing Vernon George Wells, who played Wes in Mad Max 2 The Road Warrior. Next up, we have Shell Nielsen, who played none other than the Lord Humongous. Next is Emil Minty. You might not recognize him, but he was the feral child in the film. He was only 8 years old at the time. Next, we have the beautiful Virginia Hay, the warrior woman. Last but not least, Bruce Spence, the gyro captain, also played a Gaia in Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome. So the way this is going to work, we're going to ask a few questions, and then later on we're going to open it up for questions out in the audience. So think about what you want to ask these guys. I think the first question we're going to ask is, if you guys are all ready.